This is me, and this is my mate Marty, and we like cars. Lots of cars. We love buying them, fixing them, modifying them, racing them, and even destroying them. We've driven cars in countries all over the world, but now we're setting our sights on our very own backyard, the Australian Outback. We'll be starting in Sydney on the East Coast and travelling west to one of the most desolate and dangerous places on the planet, Central Australia. And to get there, we're going to try and borrow cars from people we meet along the way. This is Lend Us a Ride, Australia. Previously on Lend Us a Ride Australia, we began our journey in a dodgy electric car, borrowed a V8 DeLorean, a Buick and a turbocharged Daihatsu. It was the worst weather imaginable, but we've successfully made our way across the Blue Mountains.
This is Parkes, 350 kilometres west of Sydney. It's got 10,000 people in it who like to farm and mine stuff, and they like Elvis. Yep, Parkes is home to the annual Elvis Festival, where trainloads of Elvis impersonators come up here once a year to, well, be Elvis. So far, we've been able to borrow cars from mates and people we know, but now that we're in Parkes, there's no more favours. So today, we have to go and find ourselves another car.
We've had word that there might be a car that we can borrow just outside of town. So we're on our way to a very large dish.
Awesome, man. Yeah, tell him to look for the big telescope thing.
James's parents are going to come and pick up his car. And that really is a big dish. We've arrived at the CSIRO radio telescope in Parkes.
This telescope tracked Apollo 11 on the moon and received television signals from the moon landing. It almost got blown off its foundations by strong winds that day, but the astronomers held their nerve so 600 million people around the world could watch the landing. Over the years, the dish has been modified to be 10,000 times more sensitive than when it was first built, and it's arguably the finest single-dish radio telescope in the world. Its design makes it an ideal instrument for tracking spacecraft in deep space. Australia leads the world in radio astronomy. This telescope has discovered more pulsars than all the other telescopes in the world combined.
We're meeting up with John, who's been working out here at the dish for years, and he's going to give us a tour of the telescope and hopefully lend us a car.
And it was commissioned back in October of 1961, so this year we'll be commemorating 53 years of operation. But when it was built, it was only intended to have a lifetime of 20 years, so we've well and truly exceeded that.
The idea of this telescope is to pick up minuscule radio frequencies in space and amplify them, and it's powerful. If you had a mobile phone on the moon, which is 400,000 kilometres away, it would be one of the strongest radio signal sources in the sky. And the whole thing is now accessed via the internet, with people logging in to control the telescope from all over the world.
So at the moment, somebody's on the internet, they've got YouTube open in one window, Facebook open in another window, the third window, they're controlling this.
That's right.
This telescope, is that right?
Yep. Okay, it's time to fess up and tell John that we need a car.
Part of the reason that we're here, of course, was to hear about the dish. But this morning when we were out in Parkes having breakfast, we heard that maybe you have a car that you could possibly lend us for a few days.
Oh, who told you that?
We promised that we wouldn't say who it was, but we do need a car for a couple of days if you could lend us one.
Okay, well, I think we can do something for you, but, we're pretty busy today and we are short-staffed.
Maybe we could help out, because we actually do need a car.
We need a car today. Like, if we don't have a car today, we're stuck in Parkes.
Okay, well, do either of you have any astrophysics expertise?
Well, we do know how to clean and scrub toilets, and John said that if we helped out around the dish for the afternoon, he'd lend us a car.
Thanks, John. Jobs are all done.
Oh, it was a pleasure.
It was an amazing day, mate, and I'm pretty excited about your car.
Oh, that's right. Al?
Yep?
Give him the keys.
Keys?
Yeah, to your car.
It's my car.
This is your car, is it?
Yep.
Where is it?
It's in the car park.
Thanks a lot, guys.
This is a 1992 Ford Capri XR2 Turbo. The Ford Motor Company had been using the Capri name since the 1960s, reviving it again in 1989 for the Italian-designed four-seat convertible. These are actually Australian-made cars, built in Homebush in Sydney. 66,000 of them were made, but only 9,000 stayed in Australia. Most of them were exported to the US in left-hand drive. When they were released, the car was penned as having problems, mainly to do with leaking roofs. But they have survived the test of time, with many still on the road today, such as this one, largely due to the robustness of the Mazda 323 platform they were based on. We can't work out how to use the roof, but that doesn't matter because it's a beautiful day for a drive in the country.
Okay, it is bucketing down now. The roof is off, and by some aerodynamic brilliance, we are not getting wet at all.
After a torrential downpour, the weather cleared up. But we realised this car is completely unsuitable for outback travel.
Australian roads are shared by cars, trucks, road trains, bikes and animals. Animal proofing the front of a car is vital for safety from kamikaze kangaroos.
G'day, mate. How are you going?
Yeah, good, buddy. How are you?
Good, thank you. Mate, we've got a Ford Capri, and we're heading out of town tomorrow, and we need a bull bar, because we heard there's a lot of kangaroos on the road out towards Cobar. Have you got a bull bar for a Capri?
Bull bar for a Capri? No, I don't think they make them.
Have you got a bull bar for anything that you reckon we can kind of fit on there?
This is Parks Auto Wreckers, and we're on the hunt for a few parts to convert our car into something that's a bit more suitable for outback travel. And we've found just the guy to help us.
Neville, tell us a bit about this place, man. There's a lot of cars.
Well, we've been here for 27 years.
Yep.
Doing what we do. We sell car parts all over Australia.
Yep.
How many cars you got here, Neville?
800 plus.
Wow. There's a bit of variety too. So we need like roof shooting related paraphernalia. So we're thinking bull bars, we're thinking racks.
We'll have bull bars. We'll have a bull bar down here.
All right.
Plenty of stuff there on Land Cruisers.
Probably a bit big though, isn't it?
Yeah.
And we've got an hole on that there. We'll be off that Rodeo too. Maybe that's something that we can...
Oh, yeah, I reckon that has Capri written all over it. What do you reckon,
man? I reckon if we chop it down, that'll work.
Chop the bottom off?
Yeah, because we just need the top bit, don't we, for our big car.
Sold. I'll grab that.
This is a taxi.
It is a taxi, man. Oh. I think this is one. I remember vomiting in this one once. I'm sure it was me.
This will work.
Wow, airbag's gone off. I wonder if they had to pay full fare.
So you had a box of beer and a pizza?
Yeah, that's right.
Lovely.
This will work,
won't it? So do something with that?
Yep. That's perfect. Look at that.
That would hold a whole kangaroo, wouldn't it?
Well, we want to mount that flat and then Oki straps over the kangaroo.
Yep.
And then, you know what? Oki straps off over hot coals, bang, there's dinner.
Genius.
Barbecue.
Sold.
Beautiful.
Sold.
Let's go.
We've picked up a few essentials, and after getting kicked in the balls by their dog, it was time to get the parts into the car, which was easier said than done.
Why do I always get this job? Why does my job have to be holding the very dangerous, heavy parts?
Dude, you're behind a bull bar.
You're
the safest person out of both of us right now. If we hit a roof, right in the face for you. Bing bong.
Yeah,
bye-bye,
no
Skippy.
Bye-bye, kneecap.
No.
Bye-bye, face.
You'll be fine, mate.
No, mate. I will not be fine.
You will be absolutely fine.
And I'm holding onto this stupid kangaroo grill that you bought.
A kangaroo grill.
I'm still not happy about this.
Are you serious? This is as good as it gets. This is the automotive dream right now, mate. What I'm not happy about, Marty, is the only way that I know how to go is straight through the middle of town.
Nah, man, come on.
I don't know which other way to go.
Dude, there's like, these towns are always grids. You can just go left and right.
This town is not a grid. Melbourne is that way, Brisbane's that way. Where we need to go is that way.
No, it's there, a massive train.
That is a
big
train, mate.
There's bugs crawling on me.
Yeah, well, it's been sitting outside in a wrecking yard.
Is that a redback web?
I think so, mate. I think, it's only the female redbacks that you need to worry about. I think the male redbacks are not aggressive and not poisonous.
How will I know if it's a female redback?
You'll die. You'll start dying. Really, really painful sting. Numb, vomiting, nausea, and eventually death. There is a hospital in Parkes though, so as long as I get you there in time. No one's died from a redback bite in Australia for a couple of decades. So
do you know what no one else has been doing in Australia for decades?
What's that, mate?
Holding a freaking bull bar in an XR2 Capri while his dickhead mate drives him to the middle of town.
Cops! Dude. Cops! Cops! Because pulling our hat down will mean they won't pull us over, Martin.
Just crouch and then the bull bar
I'm hanging
will go
a left.
Lower.
I'm hanging a left. I'm hanging a left. I'm hanging a left.
Did they see it?
They kept driving. Keep driving. Do they keep driving?
Yeah, we're good.
I was looking up to the rear vision mirror and there is not one there.
Well, there isn't either. Why is there no. There's a thing, a sticky for it. Oh, wait.
You found it! Great!
Okay, maybe if I just hold it. Is that good?
That's safe.
Is that safe? Is that helping?
All I can see is you, so it's not ideal.
We've met some local truck mechanics, Gary and Lyndon, who've kindly offered us the use of their workshop for the afternoon. They're also going to give us some tips on how we can turn our Capri into an outback munching beast.
Amazing. Let's go, man.
Bit of help would be good.
Oh,
thank you.
Sorry.
There's a spider between my legs, man.
Again. Got it.
You right?
Yep.
Taking my roo barbecue.
So Gary and Lyndon, thank you for helping us turn our little car into a roo shooter. Here is the beast. What do you guys think?
Oh my God.
You love it?
A roo shooter.
Yeah, it's going to be a roo shooter.
Well, it's going to have a lot of modification.
That's a good thing.
It is.
What do you think, dog?
Okay.
So we're thinking basically big bull bar on the front, luggage tray on the back.
Right.
And then we reckon that'll be a pretty safe car to kind of continue out into the outback. Have you got any kind of advice or thoughts on that?
Well, all I can say is there's some very, very big roos out there.
Yeah. Tasty ones?
Pigs.
Oh.
A lot of pigs. Like hitting a house brick.
Okay.
When you hit them. I'd have thought just perhaps a little bit inadequate, but time will tell when you start on your mods.
That's the right attitude. Isn't
that
it?
Is the right attitude.
You
know, I like
if you
that.
Get the right mods on it. I can see it's going to do a job.
Yeah, I don't think there's much difference, like really, between this and that.
No, not at all.
It's going to have a bull bar.
Just the size and the strength and the durability and scrub basher bar and, there's not a lot of difference other than that.
It's going to have trouble mounting the spotlight in the roof.
Trouble mounting a spotlight in the
no,
roof.
No, we're going to mount the spotlights on the front bull bar.
On the bull bar.
Of course, apparently that's the way to do it.
Right, we've got just the thing for that. Yes,
great, so can you guys help us convert this into an outback smashing roof crushing machine?
Look, it would be an absolute pleasure, and I can see that it's going to be bigger than Ben-Hur.
Gary's had his eye on our Capri ever since we got here. He's been standing there looking at it all sexy.
I think you can see yourself in it.
Yeah, I think he likes it.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking what we could do is a swap, plus a little cash our way.
Your car for
this, plus a little bit of moolah for our trouble. And you know what? You are going to be defeating the most mightiest of kangaroos out there. And meanwhile, look, it's a downgrade, but we can take yours.
Gary gave us some advice on how to modify our car.
So Gary, can you give me a couple of tips? This obviously sees a lot of outback, right? What are the must-have items for a roo-destroying outback machine to give us some inspiration for our Capri?
Got to have a spotlight on the roof.
And you control it like this, like a periscope?
Yep.
What else do we need? Oh, there it is. Look at that. Look at that. That's amazing. What other must-haves?
Got to have a UHF.
UHF. This looks a little bit better than ours.
Does it?
Yeah, well, we got a couple for $19, a pack of two.
Yeah, fair enough.
We got a range of around 200 metres. How far does this go?
Yeah, 100 k's at best.
What do you reckon?
Oh, it'll do.
100 kilometres?
Sometimes.
Really? Yeah. We literally get around 200 metres line of sight.
Yeah. No.
This was from Toys R Us. Right. It was awesome.
We moved the trucks out of the way and cleaned ourselves up a corner where we could create our desert-destroying Capri. And we have a coolant leak.
Now, we wouldn't usually modify someone else's car without permission, but this is not the safest choice for outback travel. So we rang the guys at the Dish to ask if we could make some minor adjustments, and they said that was fine. In fact, they said we could drive it until it blows up, which they expected to happen at any moment. And if by some miracle it didn't go up in smoke, it was also about to run out of registration in a couple of days. This is not looking good at all, and it's about to get worse.
It wasn't until we got under the car that we realised this Capri is home to thousands of species of spiders.
So we're either going to blow up, run out of rego, or get bitten by a redback spider, or maybe even all of the above.
Unreal. Thanks, Neville. Neville from the wrecker has got some more mad stuff for our car, so I need to get down there and all pick right. It up before he closes.
Cool, man. Well, you can't take this because we're halfway through.
Gary, I gotta get to the wreckers. Can you lend me a ride?
Yeah, break it your bike, mate.
Deal. Thanks, mate.
The Australian bush is tough, so you need a tough machine to deal with it. This is Gary's Toyota Land Cruiser. It's got a bull bar, winch, homemade toolboxes, powerful CB, and an epic roof spotlight. It runs on diesel, so it isn't fast, but it doesn't need to be, because this is a proper working ute, the kind you see working all over Australia. Unlike some of the utes you see blinging around the city, this is a real ute, to do real ute things, like herding animals, crossing rivers, chasing pigs, making babies, cruising your farmland, and going to the wreckers to get awesome parts for your Ford Capri.
Your blokes are madder than me. They're a very, very hospitable bunch around here.
Yeah.
G'day, mate.
There we go, Jebby. There we go.
Amazing.
Not very long, but
sold. Yeah, it's a silver Elantra that looks like it's hit a wombat.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the right one, man. Those wheels should fit.
Have a good day, mate. Thank you very much.
You too.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
See you next time.
Goodbye, guys.
The Capri needed some new tyres, but we couldn't find any the right size, so we just bought some rims that were already wrapped in better rubber that's going to be more suitable for outback travel.
Meanwhile, I'm going to make this thing fit the front of our car, chopping as much weight out of it as I can and then welding up mounts to the front of the Capri.
I've got one more stop to make.
I have got everything that I need, and now it is back to the workshop, which I know is around here somewhere. Oh, there it is.
We've got everything we need to modify this car, but we've only got the shed for another few hours, so it's going to be a busy afternoon.